Hello and welcome to the tutorial for the Home and Community-Based Services Online Attestation Form. My name is Dan Goldstein and I will be guiding you through this tutorial. This tutorial will cover the following topics. Part 1, logging into the online form for the first time. Part 2, navigating the online attestation form. Part 3, adding attachments. And Part 4, how to save and submit your attestation. If you want to advance this video to a specific topic, the timestamps are as follows. Part 1, logging into the online form for the first time, 53 seconds. Part 2, navigating the online attestation form, 4 minutes, 23 seconds. Part 3, adding attachments, 5 minutes, 41 seconds. And Part 4, how to save and submit your attestation, 9 minutes, 41 seconds. Let's get started with our first tutorial, logging into the online form for the first time. The first thing you need to do is open a browser and go to the following URL, https://edocs.dhs.state.mn.us/lfservr/secure/dhs-7176-eng. This URL will bring you to the online attestation form, which has the Minnesota Department of Human Services logo in the upper left-hand corner and has the following title at the top. Home and Community-Based Services, parentheses, HCBS, Provider Attestation. If you are logging in for the first time, scroll to the bottom of the page and click on the button in front of New Attestation. Once you click on the button, notice that some additional fields and information appear at the bottom of the page. Click your cursor into the field that is labeled License or HFID, and then type in your license or HFID number, and then click the Lookup button. If your license or HFID number is not accepted, you will receive an error notification. If you are not able to proceed to the next page, recheck your number or look it up online using the links below this field at the very bottom of the page. The DHS license lookup link will open another tab or browser where you can search for your license number based on information about your setting. If you are a customized living provider and do not know your HFID number, you can click on the Customized Living HFID Lookup link. This will open another tab or browser where you can search for your HFID number based on information about your setting. If you are still unable to enter a valid number, please email hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. That is hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. Use the subject line, sign in number for attestation needed. Please include your provider name, the setting address, city, state, zip code, phone number, and the provider service type at the setting. Once you have your number, go back to the online attestation form and click your cursor into the field that is labeled License or HFID, and then type in your license or HFID number. Then click on the Lookup button. If your license number is recognized, a new button that says Start Attestation will appear in the lower right-hand corner of the page. Click on this button to start your attestation. You will now be on the next page of the online attestation form. This is the Provider Information page. You will notice that your license or HFID number is already entered in the first field of this page. From this point, you can continue through the attestation form. We will now move on to navigating the online attestation form. If you have just logged in, you will be starting on the Provider Information page on the online HCBS Provider Attestation form. You will notice that there are some buttons and fields at the top of this page which will help you navigate your way through the form. First, you can use the Next and Previous buttons to go page by page, forwards and backwards through the form. Please be sure to use these buttons instead of the back and forward functionality built into your browser. For example, I am using Chrome as my browser and it has two arrows next to the URL that can be used to navigate a website. Do not use these. You can also navigate the form by using the Table of Contents drop-down menu. This is located between the previous and next buttons and should currently say Provider Information, which is the page we are currently on. If you click on the down arrow on the far right-hand end of this box, it will open the drop-down menu with the Table of Contents on the form. Go ahead and click on the last line, Attachments, and Save or Submit. This will take you directly to the last page in the form. You can jump back and forth to any page using the drop-down menu. Note that you will not lose any information by jumping back and forth through the form. So we've shown you how to log in for the first time and how to navigate the form. Now let's walk through how to add attachments. Let's pause for a moment and talk about why and when you will be adding attachments. Most of the questions in the attestation form require you to provide documentation to show you meet the new requirement. So, you will need to add this documentation as attachments to your online attestation. You can add attachments at any time. However, attachments will only be saved when you click on the Submit Attestation button. Attachments will not be saved if you click on the Save and Exit button. Also, you will need to complete all the required fields before you can click on the Submit Attestation button. So, our suggestion is that you wait to attach your documents until you have completed the entire form and are ready to submit. Let's jump in and look at the details. First, navigate your way to the Attachments and Save or Submit page of the form. Remember, you can use the drop-down menu at the top of the page to jump right to this page. Before you add your attachments, it is a good idea to have them saved somewhere you can easily find them on your computer. Once you have your documents ready to go ahead and click on the Attach Required Documents button. This will bring you to a new page within your browser. From here, you can add files by accessing your computer. In the left-hand column, there are several buttons. We will begin by clicking on the Add File button. This will open a dialog box of your file manager. Depending on your computer and your file manager, your screen may look different than what you see in this video. Regardless, you should be able to navigate your file manager to find the first file you want to attach. In my example, I am selecting a file named Example, Residency Agreement or Lease. If you have more than one file in this view, you can select multiple files at this point. I am now also selecting Example, Recipient Rights Form PDF. Once you have selected your file or files, click on Open in the dialog box. The dialog box will close and you will now notice another smaller dialog box. You should be able to see the files you just selected in this dialog box. In my example, I can see that both files I selected are included. To complete the process, go ahead and click on the Add button in the lower right-hand corner of the dialog box. To add more files, repeat this process. When you are done adding your files, click on the Finish button at the top of the left-hand column. This will bring you back to the Attachments and Save or Submit page of the attestation form. You should see the documents you attached in the list of attached documents section on this page. Now, you need to assign a document type to each document you attached. To do this, click on the down arrow of the drop-down menu next to your document and select the appropriate document type. In my example, I am selecting Residency Agreement or Lease for my example Residency Agreement or Lease document. Remember, you must select a document type for each attachment. When you are done, you must select Submit Attestation at the bottom of this page. If you select Save and Exit, these attachments will not be saved. Let me repeat that. If you select Save and Exit, these attachments will not be saved. Also, it is important to understand that all required fields must be completed before you click on Submit Attestation. So, as I mentioned at the beginning of this section, it is our suggestion that you wait to attach your documents until you have completed the entire form and are ready to submit it. We will be covering how to save or submit your attestation in the next section. We have touched on a few elements of this topic already, but let's focus now on how to save and submit your attestation. The key thing to keep in mind is that there are two ways to end your session when working on the online form. You can either save and exit the form, or you can submit your attestation. Let's walk through the differences. As you navigate the form, you will notice that there is a save and exit button in the upper right-hand corner of every page of the form, except the first and last page. If you want to save your work and come back later, you can click this button on any page at any time. However, as I click on the button, you will see that I get an error. The first error is related to the attachments, which we covered in the previous section. As a reminder, if you click on the Save and Exit button, any attachments you have added will not be saved. You can click on OK to get rid of this error box. When you click on Save and Exit again, the next few errors are related to the two required fields you must complete before you can save your work and exit. The first field is on the Provider Information page. When I click on OK in the error box, it will take me to this page. You must answer the last question on this page. You must indicate whether you intend to meet the HCBS requirements at this setting. After answering that question, click on Save and Exit again and you will get another error. This second error is on the Attachments and Save or Submit page. On this page, you need to provide and confirm your email address. I recommend that you write down this email address along with your license number, perhaps in your printed guidebook, as you will need it to log back into the form. You should be able to click on the Save and Exit button now successfully. You can come back to the form and update your information and save and exit whenever and as many times as you want. Now, let's review how to submit your attestation. Recall that you will need to complete all the required fields in the form before you can submit your attestation. Next, you will need to add all your attachments to demonstrate that you meet the new requirements. The details on how to add these attachments was covered in the previous section. Once you have added all your attachments and completed all required fields, you are ready to click on the Submit Attestation button at the bottom of the form. You will receive an automatic email confirming that the system has received your submitted attestation. You can also come back to the form and update your responses, and you can submit your attestation again. For example, changing a Do Not Yet Comply response to Comply whenever and as many times as you want. We encourage you to update your attestation with your ongoing progress. Thank you for watching our HCBS online attestation form tutorial. For more information on home and community-based services, visit mn.gov/DHS/HCBS. That is mn.gov/DHS/HCBS. If you have any additional questions about using and navigating the online form, please send them to hcbs.settings@state.mn.us. That is hcbs.settings@state.mn.us.